If you are watching this video, I believe you are a forex trader and you are having hard times trading. What I mean by that is maybe you are losing your hard-earned money on trades, or you are breaking even on almost every trade, or you are not making enough profits. So this video is aimed at sharing some techniques and tips on how you can increase your trading profits on a daily basis. So let's begin. First, what is risk? Risk is simply the potential loss which happens if a price moves against your projected trade direction. And risk management are the precautions and strategies taken to reduce the loss of trading capital. So the overall is like money management, and this is simply capital preservation. In forex trading, if you can't win on your trade, you should not lose your trading capital. That is the number one rule. If you can't win, don't lose your trading capital. So always have that at the back of your mind when you are trading. Risk management is the only holy grail in forex trading. Why I say this is because even if you have a very, very poor trading strategy and you have a good risk or money management model you are using, you will not lose your trading capital within a month or two. At least before you should lose the account, you get to know what you are doing wrong and you correct them immediately. So that's why I always encourage and I always tell traders that they should use proper risk and money management when trading. That is the only holy grail in forex trading. According to research, 87% of traders lose money because of poor risk management. I'm not the one that this is the researcher. Maybe it's the Bureau of Statistics, if there is anything like that. But to be on a serious note, risk management is the only holy grail. It's not about your trading strategy. It's not about your robot. It's not about your expert advisors. It's the risk management model. If you have a good risk management model, you are good in forex trading. There is this common debate among traders that which risk to reward ratio is good. So here is a comparison I did between using a 1:2 risk to reward ratio and a 1:3 risk to reward ratio using a $100 trading account. If we should look at this other table here shows you trades that are being taken with 1:2 risk to reward, and here are trades that are being taken with 1:3 risk to reward. So assuming you have a $100 account and you are taking five positions, like five different trades, and you are risking, let's say, $20 of that account to make $40. Let's say you take five trades, and in a worst case scenario, three trades hits your stop loss. This is three trades hitting your stop loss and you lose three trades, and while you win on only two trades, at the end of the day you would realize that you'll be making only $80, and overall you're on a loss because you'll be left with just $80 on your account. But if you are using a 1:3 risk to reward ratio, let's say you are risking $20 to earn $60, so you take five trades, and in a worst case scenario, three trades hit your stop loss and you win on only two trades, you realize that you'll be making $120. So you have recovered your losses and still made a profit on it too. So that is why I recommend you should be using 1:3 risk to reward ratio. If you use 1:3 risk to reward ratio, you are going to be very, very safe when you are trading. 1:2 is good, but 1:3 is better. So I prefer 1:3. I recommend 1:3. So start using 1:3 risk to reward ratio. If you are a day trader or a swing trader, this is better, 1:3. Now, always take partial profits. When trading, some traders get greedy. What I mean by they get greedy, for example, they take a trade and a trade is on their profit and is about to approach their take profit, and all they do is that they shift their take profit higher feeling that the price will keep pushing higher. That is not good. That is not right. You shouldn't be shifting your take profit higher. Instead, you should take partials. Like for example, you are using standard loss size. You can close 0.50 loss size, like half. You take half of the profits off, or more than half off, and allow the rest to be running while you are trailing your stop loss. So it's not good to be greedy. So always take partials. If you feel, okay, fine, the trend is still going to go higher, just take partials, then trail your stop loss. Don't just extend your take profit while you are not taking any partial, and you don't know about what will happen. You are not the one controlling the market. Anything can happen. So you may see price coming down and take you out on maybe BE on your entry or on your stop loss at the end of the day. You have been signing up for Forex signals here and there, and you are jumping from one Forex signal provider to the other. Maybe you say it's not profitable, their signals are not correct, but these are few reasons why you are still losing money using a signal service. One is because you lack trading skills. Now, for example, you are in a signal service group or platform, and a signal was dropped and the entry was, let's say, 1.201, and let's say it was a sell entry, and by the time you saw the signal, price have already moved and it's at 1.103. So this was the initial signal entry and price is now here. You don't need to jump right into the trade because price have already moved away, few pips away from the entry. All you need to do is you have to wait for price to retest the entry. When price retests the entry, then you can join. Better still, you can set a pending order using the same trade parameters, that is the stop loss and the take profit. You use the same parameters, because if you jump in into that trade in the current market price, which price have already moved, you may be taking a wrong trade because the risk to reward there is now very, very poor. And at the end of the day, if price should end up hitting your stop loss, you lose more money than others who take the trades on time. Two is the wrong trading mindset. Now, so many of us, we are very emotional, and when you lose a trade, you have this revenge mindset, like, wow, I have to make back this money, I have to make back this money. No, you don't have to have that kind of mindset. That kind of mindset consumes you, it kills your trading accounts, because that will put you under pressure to be doing analysis, and you may be trading on an impulse and jumping on trade that are not ready to move. So it's very, very bad. Then poor risk management, because you are not using a good risk management, that is why you're also losing trades using a signal service provider. Let's say your signal service provider sends you 4 signals in a day, and you are having a very small trading account balance. Now, you need to calculate your risks on each trade and take on your small account, because if your account is not big enough to hold any retracement of those trades, you end up still losing your account. So for example, a signal service sends you 4 trades. You don't need to take the 4 trades if you are trading with a small account. Just take like 2 and let it run first. When you are on profit, you can take the remaining 2. These are the few reasons why you are still losing money using signal. These are steps to help you earn more from Forex trading. One, you need to develop your trading plan and you have to follow it. You need to be disciplined. By trading plan, I mean you set your trading goals. For example, you say, okay, I want to be making $5 each day, or I want to be making $10 each day. So your trading plan should include your trading goals, should include your trading strategies, like your entries and your exits, the number of pips you may likely need for your stop loss or your take profits. So try and develop a trading plan, and you have to be disciplined and follow your trading plan. If you should see any trade set up and it does not fit into what you had on your trading plan, don't take the trade. 2 is stick to one trading strategy. Stop jumping from one strategy to another trading strategy. It doesn't make sense for you. You end up confusing yourself and losing more money. So look for one trading strategy, that suits your trading style and personality and focus on it. Focus on one trading strategy. Trade that strategy for like 4 to 6 months, if possible a year. You have to backtest your trading strategy. When it's perfect, that is when you can now fund heavy cash and use your strategy. When you are testing a strategy, you don't need to fund your account with heavy sum. Just use a small amount of money and test your trading strategy. Or better still, you can use a demo account and test your trading strategy. You need to know your risk tolerance too. What I mean by risk tolerance, you know, for example, let's say you have a $100 account, and definitely if you have a trade running and the trade is running on the -$50, you start panicking. So what I mean by risk tolerance is that amount, that if you are losing, it will not disturb you emotionally, because emotions is a real killer to traders. So you look for that amount, I mean that figure, that even if you should lose such money, it won't affect your psychology, it won't affect your mindset. So when you discover that, okay, fine, if I'm losing, let's say $30 in a day, it will not affect me, I will still be living, I will still be alive, and that means that is your risk tolerance. So you need to understand and know your risk tolerance. When you know your risk tolerance, your trade should not exceed your risk tolerance. So when you do this, you will see that in few weeks or months, you'll be earning more money from trading. These are a few risk management precautions when you are trading. One, you need to determine your exit levels before taking a trade. If you have been taking trades on impulse, for example, you just see price moving up and you jump into a trade, that is very, very wrong. You don't need to be trading on impulse. Now, what you need to do is that when you see that price is moving, you need to predetermine where are you entering this trade and at where are you leaving the trade, either on loss or a profit. So when taking a trade, you need to determine your stop loss and your take profit first. And you need to be very realistic. Don't set trading goals like, I want to make, let's say for example, you are trading with like 100 USD account and you say, I want to double my money in a day. I know it's possible in trading, but that is pressure. You'll be applying pressure on your trading, and it's not good. So you have to be very realistic in setting your trading goals and your risk to reward. Don't go setting a risk to reward of 1:10. Except you can set 1:10 risk to reward if you want to wait a whole month for that trade to manifest. Then admit when you are wrong and move on. If your trade should hit stop loss, don't panic. You have to be calm. Just know that, okay, fine, maybe you are wrong. Just admit that you are wrong and you move on. Don't let the emotion engulf you. Because when the emotion engulfs you, you start aggressive trading. And you really need to avoid aggressive trading. Ideal equity risk is 5 to 7%. And what I mean by equity is that, let's say you have a $100 account balance. You should not risk more than 7% or maximum 10% of that your account balance on a trade per time. For example, in a day, let's say your equity is $100. If you are taking trades, what you are risking on those trades, you should not exceed 10%. No matter what you are doing, no matter the number of your trades, let your risk don't exceed 10%. If you can do 5 to 7% risk, it's better, but maximum 10%. Personally, I do 7% risk. I don't exceed 7%. You need to risk small to earn higher. The number one problem of a trader is emotions, and it's being derived from watching a losing trade turn deeper against them. So learn how to cut losses and ride your winning trades. Let's say you take a trade and maybe your stop loss was very wide and you realize that it's going deeper. This will be affecting you emotionally. If that is happening, you need to cut out that trade and allow your winning trades to run. This will help build your trading mindset and psychology and put you on the right frame of mind for you to analyze the market and take more trades. If you risk small, nothing can destroy you. This is what I always have on my mind every time I sit down to trade. So I want you to also have this written down and be looking at it every day before you jump into the charts to trade. Remember, if you should risk more, nothing can destroy you. Reduce your risks and maximize your profits. That is how to trade. Thank you for your time for going through this lengthy piece. I believe this was helpful for you. You have learned a thing or two from it. If you need more Forex trading secrets that can help you earn your first $100, click the link below this video. This is the link here. You see it below this video. And I will share some Forex trading secrets with you. Thank you for your time. Make sure you click the link.